is Maria Becerra. I'm the Executive Director for the East Chicago Redevelopment Department, and I'm here with Ms. Jackie Simpson. We're going to go over some exciting things that our department is involved in and that the city is partnering with us on a few things. So Jackie, if you would start out with...
One of the things that we're getting ready to start and embark on, which we're really excited about, is the Showcasing East Chicago. And this is an event where we want the community, the citizens of East Chicago, to realize all of the things that are going on within the city of East Chicago under the direction of Mayor Anthony Copeland. On Friday, November 30th, we're going to have a Showcasing East Chicago, sort of kind of like an extravaganza that's going to be held at the East Chicago Marina from 12 o'clock until 6. And 6 o'clock, we chose 6 o'clock because by the time people get off, they can come through and they can get a chance to see what's going on in the city, and you're going to get a chance to meet some of the newest homeowners within the city of East Chicago. The mayor will be presenting them with certain things. But like I said earlier, we're excited about all the things that are going on. You're going to see, you know, buildings coming up and homes. And we're just encouraging people that lived in the city to come back home and to participate in the programs that are going on. And for those people that are here that want to upgrade, we have plenty brand new homes on Washington Square that are going to be available. So you just need to contact the Department of Redevelopment. We're located at 400 East Chicago Avenue, which is the Water Department building. And if you have a pencil, our number is 391-8513, and you'll be hearing more about that later on in the show. Thanks.
And as far as Washington Square, I think we need to talk a little bit, for those that are watching this, as what is being built. Please take the time to pass by the old Washington Square, Washington High School. Subdivision that we are finishing right now. We have two-story homes.
Right.
We have tri-levels. It will be quality built. The builder that is building them is Phillippe Builders out of St. John. Right now, we are looking at all brick homes,
right.
Three bedrooms, all of them with two baths, two-car garages,
right.
Attached garages, and we're really excited. You're going to have granite countertop. The nice thing about it is basically because of the funding that we receive through the NSP and its neighborhood stabilization program, we are able to build the homes, close to $200,000 homes that we're building. But because of the funding that needs to be used in terms of stabilizing the neighborhood, our department is able to give what they call a soft second mortgage. So even though it cost us $200,000, we can do a soft second where maybe you would only have to qualify, for example, for $120,000.
Right.
And with our down payment assistance program, we will have one of our other staff members joining us shortly to talk about the great down payment assistance programs that the city is giving as incentives to encourage people to purchase homes in the city.
Right.
And those incentives are large incentives, $25,000 for new construction. So I won't take all of his thunder. We'll have Mr. Smith joining us shortly to talk about that.
And we also want to thank the East Chicago Foundations because they're also a partner in this endeavor. So we're really excited about
East Chicago
everyone
Foundations
that's involved. Right.
Yes, they donated 6 parcels. And that's only phase one. That's the other part of the program. As soon as those homes are sold, it actually leverages the second phase, and that's what we'll continue to do with any of the homes that we have, is the money actually just continues to recirculate back into the community. So as those homes are being sold, like I said, we continue to have the ongoing program for home ownership, and we want to increase home ownership in the city.
Right.
So coming up next, we will have Mr. Al Espinoza to talk to us a little bit about other programs that our department has. Welcome back. We have Mr. Al Espinoza with us, and he's going to talk about some of the exciting and helpful programs that we have for the citizens and the residents here in Chicago.
Good afternoon. We have, first up is the residential rehab program that the Department of Redevelopment offers to eligible homeowners. And we offer a grant of $7,500 to fix up your homes. And we'll address such things as safety and health concerns, code violations. For instance, your HVA system might need to be upgraded, your plumbing systems and electrical systems, and a variety of other home repair needs. We also, the grant, once you reach the grant amount of $7,500, any construction costs that go over that amount would be incurred as a low interest loan, and currently that's fixed at 3%. There are some processing fees that the homeowners are required to offer with that program, and that could range anywhere from around $300 to $500. And we do have a waiting list, so it is a first come, first serve type program. We receive applications. You can call our office at 391-8513. My extension is 229. We can mail you applications, or we have applications available at our office. And it's a one-time offer to homeowners. We want to afford everyone an opportunity to participate in this program. So once you've been through the program one time, that's pretty much, you know, all we can do for you at that time. And thank you.
Well, up next, we have another staff member that works for the East Chicago Redevelopment that's going to tell us other programs that we have that kind of a couple up with the homeownership and also the rehab loans that we have. Welcome back. We have Mr. Nicholas Smith here. He works also at the Chicago Redevelopment Department, and he has some exciting programs that he'd like to make sure that the word is out there so that all the citizens of East Chicago take advantage of some of the programs that we have, or if they want to move into East Chicago, he also has some programs for them.
Thank you, Ms. Becerra. One of the areas that I definitely would like to talk about today is home ownership in the city of East Chicago. This is definitely a awesome time to purchase a home in the city of East Chicago. East Chicago, we currently have a down payment assistance program where we're offering up to $25,000 in down payment assistance for a newly constructed home. And for city employees and city agency employees, they're actually eligible for $5,000 more. So it'll be $30,000 in down payment and closing cost assistance for the purchase of a newly constructed home. And the homes that are in Washington Square will qualify, the new homes that we're building in Washington Square. Then we're also offering up to $10,000 in down payment assistance toward the purchase of any existing home in the city of East Chicago. It's not limited to a specific neighborhood or any specific area of the city. It's citywide, both programs. And it's, of course, for any existing home, up to $10,000 in down payment assistance. And for city workers and city agency employees, we're offering an extra added incentive of $5,000. So it'll be up to $15,000 in down payment assistance for the city workers. So we definitely want to encourage home ownership in the city of East Chicago. Our down payment programs are not geared toward any specific region. It is citywide, and it's not just the first time home buyer program. It's for any home buyer that's willing to move to the city of East Chicago and make a home in the city of East Chicago their primary residence.
And I think it's a collaboration. What you hear Nicholas speaking of, all that has been set up or lined up, has been a collaboration with, you know, the mayor spearheading home ownership.
Definitely.
The city council approving the down payment assistance, which we call CHIP, but it's for the city, citywide, where Nicholas speaks. Our program previously was locked into a certain area or is locked into income limits, but as of June, I believe it is, that with the city council's blessing and approval on the citywide program, we've been able to help probably over 15 or 20 new homeowners in the city, because we've now unleashed in terms of where you had to purchase the home. Now it's citywide. You can purchase a home anywhere in the city, and the income limits also have been lifted. So depending on your situation, Nicholas sits down with you one-on-one, and he goes over what programs we do have available, and our goal is to work with you and to help you become a homeowner. So Definitely. The nice thing is Nicholas is there. Like I said, it is one-on-one. If you're not sure, feel free to come in. It's free. Give Nicholas a call. Come in and see him. Even if you've been discouraged in the past, don't be discouraged. If a bank or a lender has said to you in the past you don't qualify, maybe you do now. The other thing that we need to talk about that we're excited about is we're going to be contracting with a counselor that will sit with you. So maybe you're not mortgageable today, but maybe you're mortgageable in 6 months, or maybe you're mortgageable in a year. Maybe there are some things that you need to clean up or clear up, but we want to get you that key to home ownership. So we are going to hire someone on a contractual basis. It's going to be a counselor to work with you one-on-one. You know, we've had calls like that where somebody said, you know, the bank told me 6 months ago that I can't get a house. So don't let that door close. The door is cracked. That means that you are going to be able to become a homeowner. Even if you file bankruptcy, from what I understand, they can work through that, and that counselor could sit down and explain to you a plan that will get you to home ownership. The banks are also working with us. We are going to have the banks, reminder again, on November 30th, when we showcase East Chicago, we're going to have the banks there, we're going to have the realtors there. We are having an open call for any realtors that would like to come November 30th at the showcase from 12 to 6. Any realtors that would like to work with our department, we hope to have a list developed of realtors for the upcoming year. We have properties. We have other homes scattered throughout the city that we want to go ahead and sell. And if we aren't able to move some of the homes, what we are looking at, and we're developing our lease-to-purchase program. And we've been approached by several residents that would like to no longer pay rent, but they would like to, you know, purchase a home. Maybe they're not ready, but if we can do a lease-to-purchase, we're going to be looking at also having that kind of a program. But it has been a collaborative effort, like I said, with the mayor, with the council, with our department, with the state money, and also with money that we received from the U.S. Department of federal government.
And one of the requirements for the down payment assistance is an 8-hour home buyers workshop.
Right, that's right.
That is a requirement. And don't look at it as a waste of your time. It's not a waste of your time. A lot of existing homeowners have went through the class and said, man, I wish I would have known some of this information the first time I bought a house. But it is a requirement, so you do have to go through this workshop. And the next workshop that we're having is Saturday, December 8th, from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m.
At our office?
Yes, at our office, which is located at 400 East Chicago Avenue, where the water department is located.
So they should just call you?
Yes, they can call me at area code 219-391-8513, extension 267.
And Nicholas is right, and I've sat through the classes, and a lot of people had said, oh, I wish I would have known. And they cover a lot of things. They cover, you know, you should have your home inspected. You should ask questions from your banker. Just because the banker or the lender is telling you this and this and this, ask questions. Know what questions to ask. Know that you should compare, just like anything. Compare, you know, ask questions. Compare what they're charging you in terms of closing costs. What rate they're promising you. So the class, even though it is a requirement, it is a good thing. It talks about a lot of other topics.
Definitely.
You know, owning a home and the responsibility that is in terms of upkeep and so on. So
definitely,
it's a really good class. We have lunch, we have coffee,
definitely,
we have donuts. So everybody gets to know everybody. So it's a good thing. But we ask that you come to the class and just call Nicholas. And that's just one of the requirements to get the down payment assistance program.
And then we also have some, as Ms. Becerra mentioned, we do have some homes that are available for sale and also for lease to purchase.
Mm-hmm.
We definitely want to get bodies in the home. We want to get them occupied. It's better for our department. It's better for the city as a whole if these homes are occupied. And if anyone is interested in those homes, please feel free to give me a call. Again, my number is 391-8513, extension 267.
These are new homes.
New homes, definitely.
They've
these are new homes,
never
been occupied before.
Full basement.
Full basements. All of them have unfinished basements.
Three bedrooms,
2.5 baths. So they're very quality built homes.
Mm-hmm.
So if anyone is interested, please feel free to contact me. We can set up viewing showings of the home so people can take a tour, walk around. We definitely want to get them occupied.
And these homes have appliances?
So. Yes, appliances, all appliances are there. Dishwasher, stove, microwave, refrigerator, all of it is already there.
And the homes in Washington Square are going to have granite countertops.
Yes,
yes. Like you said, dishwasher. Going to be some nice homes.
Very nice homes.
One thing that we did want to touch on is the neighborhood revitalization strategy area. Right now, what we're doing is we're having community meetings. We just had a meeting at the main library on Columbus Drive, and what we're doing is we want input from the community. If area, which is the harbor, if it's designated through our department and if we get the approval from the U.S. Department of HUD, the great thing is if it's designated an NRSA area, it lifts a lot of the income restrictive requirements. So anyone that wants to participate in our rehab program or our facade program in the Sunnyside area, that the income limits will be lifted. So everyone would be able to apply for the program to get rehab loans. Mm-hmm. And the one area that we'd like to start off right away is Sunnyside, where you do have the duplexes. And we saw that if we could help one side but not the other side, that it wouldn't be a good plan, because you would have one side that looked better than the other. So we want to start with Sunnyside. But we're really excited about that, what it's called, an NRSA designation. Along those lines, speaking of the harbor, the North Harbor, everyone knows that we have the senior building that's coming up, and all the new construction that's been going on in the harbor. Along those lines, the city's going to be pursuing and applying for, through the RDA, for a lakefront application to improve. So you're going to see a lot of things happening. One thing that Mr. Espinoza did want to mention and forgot was the demolition. So we're real excited today. If you go drive down Broadway, we have some buildings, eyesores, that are coming down. So we have overall over 25 buildings that are coming down. That's Broadway and Main. Through a special grant that we got through the RDA, we've started it. It's been a tedious process. There's a lot of things that need to be done in terms of environmental. So if you see the buildings and you're wondering, well, why aren't things happening? There's just a lot of things that we have to do. We have to check with the state in terms of historical. Is the building historical? But we're finally there. The go button has been pushed, and we have two buildings coming down as of yesterday, I understand. But overall, you're going to see 20 to 25 buildings come down on, demolished on Broadway and on Main. And you'll probably, if you pass by them, you'll know which ones they are, because they're the ones that need to come down. And I think any buildings that can be salvaged or be brought back to good conditions, we're going to be working on those also. Just a reminder, November 30th from 12 to 6, at the marina, and the address is 3301 Aldis Avenue, and that's November 30th from 12 to 6. We would like any banks that would like to join us, the realtors. We do have an open call for the realtors in Northwest Indiana. Just show up. We'll give you a 5 to 10 minute opportunity to speak to our commissioners. And if you want to work with us, partner with us, we hope to have a list of realtors that we can work with in the upcoming year and years, for the properties that we do have and the homes that we have to sell. So that, I think, Nicholas, we have some other homes, the scattered site homes. We'll have some information on those homes, and also Washington Square that we'll be able to
we'll
showcase.
We'll definitely have the information as far as the addresses and some specifications for the homes as far as how many bedrooms, how many baths. So we definitely want to make this information available to everyone that's interested in purchasing a home. Another thing that we're very excited about in Showcasing East Chicago. One thing that we're very excited about is at Showcasing East Chicago, we're going to be highlighting and recognizing the new homeowners that the city of East Chicago has received here
Eric
in this past
year. Mayor Copeland will be presenting some nice, I guess, recognition for the new homeowners that we have. And over 15 people since
approximately
June.
15 to 20.
In like 3 to 4 months, there's 15 people that have actually become new homeowners.
Very excited about that. Mm-hmm. Very excited about that.
Mm-hmm. So thank you for joining us and taking the time to listen to some of the information that we have put before you. But just a reminder, we are going to have another NRSA meeting, and again, that's Neighborhood Revitalization Strategy meeting in January. Right now, we've done the preliminary meetings, but we're looking forward to that very exciting program that lifts a lot of the income requirements, or restrictions, I should say, for our rehab program in the harbor. So if you're interested, keep an eye out for the meeting that we're going to have in January. On December 4th, our 2013 and our 2012, a lot of our planning process, if you'd like to come, we have a public hearing. It's going to be at the City Hall Council Chambers on December 4th at 5 o'clock. So thank you again. Any questions, our number 391-8513. Feel free to stop in. Don't need an appointment. come in, talk to staff. Everyone's there to help. So any questions, there isn't any question that our staff, either if they can't answer it, we'll get an answer for you. Thank you.